Following a spike in the country in June this year, President Yoweri Museveni directed the newly appointed State Minister for Internal Affairs, General David Muhoozi, to oversee the installation of digital trackers in all vehicles and motorcycles in the country. According to the president, the digital monitors will be used to track crime, not to abuse people's privacy. The Minister of Transport and Works, General Edward Katumba Wamala, has said the new responsibility of registering and licensing of all vehicles will enable them to fulfill the president's directive of effectively monitoring all the vehicles. He said they would have started on this exercise earlier on, but they had a challenge of inadequate data for all the vehicles in the country.
You know, some people may not look at the security angle of having the right records of the vehicles in this country. And the vehicles are the ones which transport criminals, move criminals and others. So it has a security component, like it or not. As you are aware, His Excellency the President directed that all major vehicles be installed with a tracking device to reduce the crime. Recently, I saw among the demands which were made by the company, which is going to do that job, and what they want is an up-to-date data of all the vehicles in the country. So if we don't have a reliable database, even this kind of work would be made very difficult.
This will enable URA to concentrate on revenue collections, although they retain the responsibility for motor vehicle customs clearance.
All of you to this occasion, as Uganda Revenue Authority formally hands over the motor vehicle function to the Ministry of Works and Transport. Since 1991 date, the motor vehicle registration and licensing function has been under the Internal Revenue Department then, today known as the Domestic Taxes Department, and has been specifically carried out by the Headquarter Service Office. And I wish to take this opportunity to thank the gallant officers of Uganda Revenue Authority who have served honorably in this very busy office for the last 30 years.
General Katumba Wamala has called for more funding to enable them fulfill all the good plans that will further see safety and prosperity of the country.
Congratulations upon a successful handover.
Report by Josephine Lung-Kose for the news.